Hey guys, welcome to Destiny Academy. My name is Pramod, and in this video, we are going to cover a very important topic, which is how much time does it take to learn API testing from scratch? And this is probably one of the important question, and I guess this is the question that people are continuously asking me over the email. That okay, Pramod, I want to learn API testing from scratch, but how much time does it take? Right? It is 30 days, 30, 60 days, 1 month, 2 hours in a crash course. What is it? Right, so in this video, I'm gonna cover everything about it, and I'm gonna give you a step-by-step process to learn API testing from scratch. And so let's get started. All right, okay, guys. So let me make myself a little smaller so that you can understand what's going on. Right. So before we start the Selenium, it's not Selenium, guys. Just make sure before we start, I will. If you are interested in learning API testing, right? Because I think you are. The step one will be like this, right? So step one will be 30 days of API testing with Postman. This is a Postman series where we have created, basically we have started working even as a beginner, right? We have started our journey with API testing. So if you are a beginner, I highly recommend you to 30 days to perform this challenge, which is 30 days of API testing challenge with Postman, right? You can go to this link. It is free of cost, no cost for this, right? And after that, I will highly recommend you to move toward the 30 days of Rest Assured, where you will learn how to create your own automation framework in Java, Rest Assured about the API automation framework, right? So make sure you do that. And if you are interested in learning automation testing, if you are new, if you are a manual tester and want to move towards the automation, this is a series or this is the challenge for you. Make sure you do that. Right. So I'm going to give you the 4-step process that I highly recommend if you are starting your API testing journey. Right. So the step one will basically include about the basics of your APIs. Right. So what are these? So we have like types of APIs. What is API? What is API actually? Basics of APIs. Right. We are going to understand what are the different types of APIs like SOAP, REST and RPCs. We're going to understand the basics of HTTP, method, JSON, XML. Right. We need to understand the basics of authentication, CRUD operations in REST API. What to test, what are the different types of common bugs in API ROAST, right? We need to understand the SOAP basic also, because sometimes in the company, the SOAP, you have to do the API testing for related to the SOAP request. So make sure you learn that thing, right? In this step three, we are gonna go little deep, where now API testing is mostly divided into the two parts, which is manual as well as in automation, right? So manual testing concepts related to the type of testing that you do. So if we talk about in API testing, we do validation testing, functional, penetration, fuzz testing, security, load as well as, right? So these are different types of testings where you will mostly learn about every type of testing will include different test cases, right? So if you are starting your journey in API testing, you have to know all these kind of things, and mostly most important one is the functional testing, where you will be doing most of the stuff, right? You will be doing validation of your keys, JSON schema validation, XML schema validations, right? You're gonna write some edge cases. You have to test them, your test APIs by security point of view, right? So these kind of stuff you will be doing step by step, right? So before, I'm just saying that, okay, before learning or before getting into the time, how much time does it take? You should know the process and how much time does it take to actually perform this thing APIs, right? And what are the major concepts in APIs, right? So that's what I have discussed in step one and step two. So these are the major components about the API testing. So if you know these concepts, then only you will basically are going to start your journey with API testing, right? So now if we talk about in black box testing, you can do boundary values, equivalence partition pairwise, decision table stateless, right? So these kind of testing techniques that you can implement in your APIs, right? And there are like common bugs that you should know about the APIs that you should know also, right? So overall, in a nutshell, I'm just giving you a step one, step two, and step three process where you should know these high level concepts are first, right? And then only you will basically create in the mind that, okay, how much time does it take, right? I've seen in the like on the YouTube that people are giving you crash course of API for like 30 minutes or 1 hour or 2 hours. But I don't think that API testing specifically will take only 1 hour or 2 hour session, right? Even with the Postman, I have created a content over 15 hours, right? So it totally depends how you want to learn the API testing, right? if you are someone, if you have a speed, you are a great learner, you can definitely learn these concepts in 7 days, right? 7 to 15 days. But my point here is that if you are totally serious, if you want to move towards the advanced stuff, especially from manual to automation of these APIs, it will take around 30 days in my best case, right? Trust me, if I'm saying 30 days, it totally depend upon your speed. I've seen people learning APIs in 7 days, 6 days. But if you are talking about 1 to 2 days, it will be very difficult to do that. But you will get the initial gist of it. If you follow this step one, step two, and step three process, you will have the basic understanding is 2, 3 days. But implementation part, it will take time, and you will learn a lot during the implementations, right? So if you see, I have 30 days of API testing as well as API test 30 days of fresh issue, right? So total 60 days, right? But it's again, if you are giving 2 hours or 3 hours per day, these will be nearly around 15 to 20 days, right? So make sure it totally depend how you are putting your efforts, right? So my point here is that you have to follow this step four process, basically from step one, step two, step three, and step four. Right, and these concepts you should know first, then only you can perform the API testing on your real world project that you are doing. Right, so if you see step four, I have written only one statement, which is automation testing and rest assured framework. But trust me, guys, learning rest assured, you should have the brush up. You should have like brush up your core Java skills as well as collection skills, right? And for framework level, you're gonna learn about the how to work with Excel, JSON schemas, and all, right? So that's where it will take more time, according to me, rather than giving you a rough idea about like 7 days or 10 days, right? So it will take a time, but trust me, it's mostly around 1 month to 45 days for a normal user. Normal, I would say, a learner who is nearly a slow learner, I would say, but won't but he's serious about it, right? And it's consistently putting the efforts in it, right? So let's talk about the time taken to learn the API testing. This is actually you want from me, right? And I want to basically answer this by asking you a question, right? So why you want the time? Why you want the time? Because, right, you should have the understanding why you want that. So first, if you are already comfortable with the testing concepts, manual testing concepts especially, I'm recommending, right? Then your API testing journey, learning API testing journey will be fast, because if you are comfortable in learning, if you are comfortable in black box testing like equivalence partition, boundary value, decision table, and these kind of stuff, and if you have an understanding of security tests, penetrations, first testing, regression, validation testing, JSON schema, then your journey will be less, and it will take very less time to start implementing the concepts in APIs, right? And again, I have told you, it totally depend upon your knowledge level, right? How much knowledge that you already have if regarding your testing, especially related to software testing, right? So in a nutshell, now let's come to the last part, which is the as per my personal view, 35 to 45 days is enough, right? This is the time actually you will have understanding of Postman or manual testing concept related to it, and as well as the concepts of rest assured and API automation framework, right? I will edit it right. And but if you are giving 2 to 3 hours, it can take 15 to 20 days. I have already told you, and that is enough, guys, because you need preparation of your API testing interviews also. That will again take 1 to 2 days, right? So this is the time, I guess you got the clarity about it, and I hope you have learned love this video. Right. Thanks a lot for watching. And if you are interested, again, I'm just reiterating, make sure you click on the link below and watch the playlist sections. Right. If you want to advance your careers related to API testing, you can go to learnapitesting.com or learn.testingacademy.com, where we have like lots of different courses. You can definitely enroll. I'll see you in there, right, as well as here. Right. Thanks a lot for watching. I'll see you in the next video.